Hey, I just got this Certano B and G string bender thing. It was pretty easy to install. Comes from France, and it doesn't take that long. Actually, it's weird because shipping is included. Shipping from France, no matter where in the world you are, he ships it to you without any additional expense. And it took about a week and a half. And I just got it working yesterday. And what I didn't really expect was how much of an adjustment it would be in your right hand technique, because I do a lot of finger picking and hybrid picking, and it's really weird with those paddles on there. Right now, I'm sure you know you can get used to it, but it's difficult when you first start. But I can see where there's a lot of potential for some really cool stuff. And, you know, even if you didn't use it for playing any, like, fancy licks, it would be great for adding some kind of like pedal steel textures to a song or whatever. Anyway, so that's my plan was to go ahead and do a little introductory thing where I explored the use of that device. And then maybe in a few weeks or a month or whatever, when I get used to it, I will do another video, maybe going more into depth about the potential of that thing. So anyway, here we go. Have a listen to it. Good morning. I just installed this thing. It's a Certano bender. It's like a B bender, but it does B and G. The lower one here, closer to the floor, bends the B string, and this one bends the G string. So that's one advantage. And another advantage is I don't know if I could have got used to the standard way that B benders work, which is you have to shove down your shoulder strap every time you want to bend the string. And I don't know that, I think once I get used to this is not easy to do right off the bat either, because it throws off your right hand picking technique a lot. If you are used to muting, and I do a lot of this stuff, hybrid picking, and that's really hard to do when your hand is over these levers. However, the cool thing, another nice thing about it, you just fold these levers out of the way and it's just Telecaster. Or actually, you don't even have to put these on Telecasters. You just have to have a flat space right here where you screw this little thing on, and it doesn't do any lasting damage to your guitar except for a couple screw holes, which I suppose you could fill in. And I might end up doing that. I might end up putting this on a different guitar. I don't think you'd want to do it to, if you had like a vintage Tele or something, you might not want to do it, but but this isn't one of those. Anyway, so you got your B bender up here. A lot of classic pedal steel licks in there. And perhaps even more, if you're used to doing stuff like, this is a very different sound. Oh, let me just demonstrate it, since I don't have the technique of operating this bender down very well yet. The way I would play it if I didn't have a bender would be, but this sounds really different because it's mechanical, like a pedal steel, so it's. I don't know, it's not a slow bend up, or it's just a quick sudden jump up. So it does sound a lot more pedal steel like, I think. Anyway, I bought it from this guy named David Certano, lives in France, and it didn't take all that long to get here, maybe a little week and a half or something, I don't know. And I installed it myself, and believe me, if I can do it, you can do it, because I'm not any great handyman, that sort of thing. Adjusting the how far it lowers the pitch, or raises the pitch rather, is pretty easy. It's this middle Allen wrench right here. And once you get it originally set, you can just do it with your fingers. So if you wanted to do that while on stage, it would probably, say you wanted to go from a whole step bend on the B string, and you wanted to make that a half step bend, it'd probably take you, I don't know, a couple minutes or something. It's not, it wouldn't be instantaneous, but it wouldn't be any harder than changing, going to an open G tune or something. Takes a few minutes to get it accurate. Just that little, you don't necessarily have to carry the Allen wrench around with you, because you can do it with your fingers. Anyway, my goal, like I said, I've had this, I don't know if I did say this, but I've only had this like one day so far, and I'm trying to figure out things that would be useful to do on it. Trying to figure out how I'm going to get around it. It makes it really hard to palm mute. That is going to be a tricky issue, and I'm sure there's a way around it, but it's not going to happen on the first day. Well, this is actually the second day. I messed with it yesterday. So what I plan to do is do another one of these videos when I get the thing figured out, be that a couple weeks or a month or whatever, so I can really demonstrate the possibilities. This one is just, you know, I just wanted to show this to you guys. And it's a cool idea, and I think it's going to work out for me. Okay, anyway, that's about it for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again.